Welcome students in this session of Physics New Era channel, and here we are going to know about the gravitation chapter, and in that one different subtopics we are going to take. In that one by one, the first subtopic, it is written here, it is Newton's law of gravitation, or it is also known as Newton's inverse square law. We are going to obtain the formula for the force according to the Newton when there is a force of attraction between the two bodies. And later on, we are going to take the universal gravitational constant, and then gravitational field. How the gravitational field it is acting on the other bodies? How to define that? And then we have the intensity of gravitational field, and then at last we are going to know the relation between small g and capital G. What exactly is this small g? Small g, we know that it is a acceleration due to gravity, and capital G is a universal gravitational constant. That value we are going to capital G as well as small g we are going to know, and we are going to obtain the relation between these two one by one. Now the first, that is Newton's law of gravitation. The statement is quite simple. Every particle of matter attracts every other particle of matter with a force which is directly proportional to product of the magnitude of the masses, product of the magnitude of their masses, and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So how? Here it is, Newton's law of gravitation. Every particle of matter attracts every other particle of matter with a force which is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of their masses and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So let us see, this particle law, it is applicable for the celestial bodies as well, just like the earth, moon. So we need to consider, here it is, we have the first mass m1. See the diagram. M1 is the mass of the first body, m2 is the mass of the second body, and distance from the center is small d. Then we have the formula which is given there. F is equal to g into m1 into m2 upon d square. This is the formula. How it is obtained? Does the notation change? Yes. As per our requirement, we can change the notation. We will make it simple. How? See. Let us consider the particle. The first particle having the mass capital M, or bigger particle having the mass capital M, and smaller particle is having the mass small m, and they are separated from the centers by the distance small r. So according to the Newton's law of gravitation, gravitation is always an attractive kind of force as per its property. So force of attraction between the two bodies is directly proportional to product of the magnitude of masses. Magnitude means a value. Let us take an example. Let us consider this body is a bigger body having a mass of 500 kilogram. Other body is having the mass of 50 kilogram. This 550 is a magnitude of m and small m respectively. So F, force of attraction between the two bodies, is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of their masses and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So togetherly I am going to write F is proportional to, instead of equal to, proportional to m into m upon r square. So this can be written as F, instead of this proportionality mark, I am going to write some constant. That constant F is equal to, this is a constant, into m into small m upon r square. This constant is known as, g is a constant. This constant is known as this G is known as universal gravitational constant, and its value is equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to power minus 11 Newton meter square per kilogram square. This is the value we'll have to remember, or while solving the problem it is given. So G is the universal gravitational constant, m is the mass of the bigger body, small m is the mass of the smaller body, G is the universal gravitational constant, and r is the distance from the centers of the two body, in between the two bodies from the centers. So here it is F. This is the formula which is given by the Newton. This law is also known as inverse square law. As the distance changes, obviously it is inversely proportional to square of the distance. So distance also changes in the form of squares. That's why it is also known as inverse square law. Now, how to define the universal gravitational constant? But before that one, what exactly is the, this is having the formula, that is F is equal to gmm upon r square. So universal gravitational constant we have need to define. So this is denoted by the symbol capital G. So capital G is equal to, in this formula, capital G F R square, this is get multiplied, F R square upon mm, F R square upon capital M into small m. This is a universal gravitational constant formula. This is your Newton's formula. Now this universal gravitational constant is defined as, we cannot remember that, or we can remember that, but we are not remembering that definition. We are going to create the definition. Here it is. Universal gravitational constant is defined as force of attraction seems to be considering the distance between these two are unit. Unit means one. Mass is one. If they are unit masses, then how to define the universal gravitational constant? Universal gravitational constant is nothing but a force of attraction between the unit masses. Force of attraction between the two bodies having the unit masses and separated by a unit distance is known as a universal gravitational constant. This unit is too much complicated, sir. How we got that unit? Very simple. This is a force is having the unit Newton. Here distance between these two, it is measured in meter square. Yes, meter means meter into meter, meter square. And what about the next? Kilogram into kilogram, kilogram square. Once again, force measured in Newton, distance measured in meter. So square of that one is meter square. So this is kilogram, means it is kilogram square. This is your universal gravitational constant. What about the dimension? Hence, the dimension of this is m raised to power minus 1, l raised to power 3, t raised to power minus 2. This is your universal gravitational constant. Now we have the gravitational field. Gravitational field. How to define this gravitational field for the any body? It is one sort of imaginary region around the body in which other body experiences a force of attraction, is known as a gravitational field. Let us see the diagram. In this one, we have the earth and we have the moon, which is shown there. And in this earth and moon, there is a force of attraction. And here the imaginary sphere which is drawn around that earth. See this one. And this indicates, means it is an imaginary region around the earth. We are going to change the definition. It is an imaginary region around the body. Instead of body, we have the earth, in which the moon experiences a force of attraction that is known as gravitational field. Once again, the definition. It is an imaginary region around the body, in which other body experiences a force of attraction is known as a gravitational field. And then later on, we are going to know about intensity of gravitational field. Intensity of gravitational field. Intensity of gravitational field. In this one, if we are going to observe intensity of gravitational field, it is nothing but force of attraction acting on a unit mass. Force of attraction between the two bodies acting on unit mass, or force acting on a unit mass, is known as intensity of gravitational field. So how to get this? It is a force acting on a unit mass. So we know the formula which is given by the Newton, which is given by F is equal to G M upon R square. If this is a unit mass, let us consider this is a unit mass. Force per unit mass is nothing but your gravitational intensity of gravitational field. This is the formula for the intensity of gravitational field, denoted by the symbol E. E is equal to force per unit mass acting on a body inside the gravitational field is known as intensity of gravitational field, which is having the new formula, that is Gm upon R square. Now we need to get the relation between small g and capital G. Now we have the relation between small g and capital G, that is acceleration due to gravity and universal gravitational constant. Hence, we are going to get the relation between this relation between small g and capital G. Now for that one, I am going to consider any body which is on the earth. Seems to be this is the earth and one body it is here. Okay, now its weight is acting in downward direction, that means weight is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. As the g value varies, the weight of the body also varies. Now seems to be considering R is the radius of the earth. If capital R is the radius of the earth, then I am going to write the relation. As we know that this weight is provided by the gravitational pull, means weight is equal to the gravitational pull, we say, because here it is the weight which is always directed toward the earth or toward the center of the earth, and it is nothing but the attractive kind of force which is given by the gravitation or Newton's law of gravitation. So weight of body is equal to, or it is nothing but a gravitational force. It is nothing but gravitational force of attraction. Gravitational force. So according to Newton, already we got that. And the weight of the body is mg. If capital M is the mass of the earth and small m is the mass of this body,
or that person who is standing on the earth too much huge as compared to the earth. So mg is equal to g m m upon, here it is, the distance between these two. From the center we are going to calculate the distance. So distance on the surface of the earth, so this is a radius. So radius is a distance between the two objects. There is a force of attraction, so we have the gmm upon r square. This m cancels with this m and we got the relation at last, that is g is equal to gm upon r square, or this can be also be written as g r square is equal to gm. This is a relation between g and g, that is small g and capital G. Now one more condition we are going to know. When I need to consider earth, and above the earth, if let us consider this is the aeroplane which is passing, this is the aeroplane, okay, if this is the aeroplane and it is at a height h, it is at a height h, and r is the radius of the earth, means the total distance it is, that is small r is equal to capital R plus h. Once again keenly observe, h is the distance from the surface to the aeroplane which is passing, then h is the height from the surface, r is the radius of the earth. So I am going to write here h height from surface of earth, from surface of earth, and capital R radius of earth, radius of earth. And we have already given the equation, small r is equal to capital R plus h, radius of the earth, means always the distance it is measured from the center of the earth to the object. There is a force of attraction. If the engine of this aeroplane fails, it will fall under the influence of gravitational field. And that's why I'm going to consider now the new relation at a height h. At height h, what happened to the relation? Just here see, the equation is mg. Equation is mg. And this is the acceleration due to gravity on the surface. But here I am going to consider the gravitational, means acceleration due to gravity at a height h. So gh, mgh, this equation, mgh, instead of that one only suffix it is given. It is not in multiplication, it is suffix. So h, mgh, mg suffix h is given by g m m upon, now here it is capital R plus h whole square, or we can also write small r square. So this m cancels with this m, and height gh is equal to gm upon r plus h whole square. This is another relation that we are going to get for the acceleration due to gravity on the surface and at a height h. These are the two relations. This can be also be modified as g h in bracket r plus h whole square is equal to gm. This is the relation between acceleration due to gravity and universal gravitational constant. Hence we are going to get the highlights from the first. We saw the Newton's law. Every particle of matter attracts every other particle of matter with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. as this law it is applicable or it is given in the form of particle, it is also applicable for the celestial bodies in between there is a gravitational force. So later on we saw universal gravitational constant. Already we got the formula for that one, that is we say G is equal to Fr square upon capital M into small m, and that G can be defined as the force of attraction between the unit masses when they are separated by a unit distance is known as universal gravitational constant, and whose value already we know and it is given, that is 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 newton meter square per kilogram square. Then later on we know that value. After that one, gravitational field, or that gravitational field is defined as it is a imaginary region around the body in which other body experiences a force of attraction, is known as a gravitational field of that body. Now the next is intensity of gravitational field. Already we saw the intensity of gravitational field is nothing but force per unit mass, and hence we have calculated the force per unit mass is nothing but intensity of gravitational field. And then later on, the relation between acceleration due to gravity and universal gravitational constant. Why it is known as universal? It is applicable for the all the planets, all everywhere this G, it is constant. That's why that constant is known as universal gravitational constant. Now we got that relation on the surface and at a height h, but we'll have to keenly observe that this height, not much more greater, seems to be here. It is the height, it is small height, comparable height with the radius, and this equation it is applicable. Okay, we will stop. Thank you.